Делот родителите и наставниците на ученици кои посетуваат двојазична настава во подрачното училиште во Тетовско прелюбиште престојува една недела во Норвешка за да се запознаат со тамошните образовни искуства. Групата посети три училишта во Лилехамер и Осло, а во познатата хуманистичка академија Нансен учествуваше на обуката «Диалог за родители». Тие ги посетија училиштата Сореал во Лилехамер, Видерхајм во Ојер и Тојен во Осло. Во училиштето Сореал имаа можност да видат каков е образовниот процес во Норвешка и во што се разликува од македонското образование.
Our school is an open plan school. That means we have a big space for each grade. And then we have different furniture from usual ones. We don't have traditional desks for the pupils. We have tables. They sit in groups and they work in groups a lot. Because we think the pupils can learn from each other when they sit together. And you also learn a lot yourself. You get conscious about things you tell to another pupil. So that's why we sit in groups like this. We think it's the best for the pupils. We don't give marks until the eighth grade. But during primary school, which is 7 years, we evaluate the pupils in process all the time. And we also do tests and give them like points. It's a sort of, not marks, but sort of. But we think what make them learn best is when they are evaluated during a process of learning. When they have finished with their work, you can tell them how they're doing, and then they can do it better. They go 7 years to primary school. Then we have 3 years compulsory in what we call a lower secondary school. And then they also have the right to 3 more years in an upper secondary school. So they can go to school for 13 years.
Во Видерхајм, групата доби информации како родителите се вклучени во образовниот процес на нивните деца и за начините преку кои се спроведуваат разни активности пред цело насока на надминување на конфликтни ситуации кај учениците.
FIU is an organization, it's a parents' organization at the school, and we have one leader, a woman leader, and we have 14 class contacts who is in that organization. And that organization do different jobs at the school. Like this fall we have started a fruit project at the school, a free project for the kids. Then it's a big thing for them to deliver the fruit and
this school calls Vidarheim skole. It's a school for 6 years old to 12 years old, from the first grade to seventh grade. We have it's 6 classes. It's a school with a the second grade and the third grade are going together. It's the lowest, the sixth grade have only 8 students and the seventh grade have 23 students. So it's a big difference between the classes.
Родителите и наставниците имаа посебна можност да ја запознаат работата во училиштето Тојен во Осло, каде учениците исто така настава следат двојазично. Големата имигрантска заедница која живее во центарот на Осло, своите деца ги праќа во ова училиште.
Tøyen is a multicultural school with 30 different languages among 270 pupils who are living around this in this area. As we try to use the pupils' mother tongue in their education. So we have 48% of the teachers who are bilingual, and they teach the pupils in different languages, so they can use their mother tongue when they are educating in different subjects, as in mathematics, geography, and gymnastic, and so on. And they also will have to. They can also we offer reading and writing in their mother tongue. But they must also have a strong focus on Norwegian. So we have both Norwegian and mother tongue education as a parallel during the day.
इसमें था वो किस तरह से हम अपनी डायरी पूरी नहीं चीजें बाद में कर लेंगे तो उनके लिए अगर हम बातें करते रहेंगे तो समझ नहीं आएगा। तब इसमें मजा भी आता है और उसके बहुत सारे फायदे हैं। अब हम डायरी लिख सकते हैं, जैसे कैसे लिखेंगे डायरी, हम आपकी याद है
Посетивме три училишта во кои се одвиваше настава на својот мајчин јазик, на норвешкиот јазик, а денеска посетивме во Осло едно училиште кај што се учеше на повеќе јазичност, кои го изучуваја норвешкиот јазик, а си го изучуваја и својот мајчин јазик. Тоа ми остави најголем впечаток што видов моментално во Норвешка.
Не визитувам деца школа актуално на Норвеги. Цењајтаме, парафрсишт цењајтаме школам тоа, сепсе актуално ише јо ветам ни джу, поки ште ме треја дијата, се катар дијат националитета ќе ме сојшин, а да иште ни гнасити шо шата за нас си ме сојшин башк, лојшин башк, а тоа баш по нимине ти не знам све нјани ме тијатрин, еде, мендеј, ат, се ти там, баш по ним, и па куфар пенгесе ме нјани тијатрин.
Не остави голем впечаток, значи импресиите се големи, затоа што тие 20, значи околу 20 нации сите беа хомогени во тоа училиште. Кај нас се работи значи за две етнички групи, македонци и албанци, а таму можете да замислите 20 на нации во едно училиште да престојуваат и да бидат толку хомогени. Значи тоа е печаток и мислам дека би било добар пример да се примени секаде во ни светот, не само во прелюбиште во нашето училиште, туку и низ целата Македонија, низ целиот свет.
Кто школа ќе ги навизетуваме, те према капелчеј, ќе баш поношен кредензанси, филим умбајат, пара се ме низ оре мсемит, умбајат кредензанси, но кише дали им класа, цела класашт, ем баш и ня башк, ня си концерт, прегатичен дичка, манде и преа саја упоноте орем си имит нисте, е вен дзан се тишин мътали, но кишин чач да ангажуваме си тене. Дзан си клас с катър, умундонте мът тепър ме активитетет поноа ме ато джа.
За специфичноста на образовниот систем во Норвешка, родителите и наставниците имаа можност да се информираат на обуката во Хуманистичката академија Нансен во Лилехамер.
I think what Norway is good in, it's the relationship between the students and the teacher. And particularly, we are excellent in taking care of students with special needs. So if it is anything Macedonia can learn from Norway, it is to be more patient and work to integrate those students that have special needs. Because often I have seen that they are pushed out and they are not recognized as equal to other more bright students. I also think that in the Norwegian school system, we work more with self-confidence, with the personality, with honesty. We are not focusing so much on mathematics, geography, chemistry, learning the encyclopedia skills. So, when I'm traveling to Macedonia, I feel that there's something we can learn from you, because you are better to teach knowledge. We are better on the interpersonal relationships between the students and between the student and the teacher.
The Norwegian educational system is an inclusive system. That is to say that all children go to the same school. There are no special schools in Norway. All children are included in the school. It is a school system where they start at school at 6 years old and they go there for 10 years. Most of the schools in Norway are public schools, run by the municipalities, And only 2% of the Norwegian pupils go to private schools. Also, some 300-400 pupils are taught at home, in their home, by their parents. And that is also possible in Norway. If these pupils learn the same things at home as they would learn in the public schools.
Самата академија представува пример на делот можностите за стекнување едукација во Норвешка. Таму се одвива неформално образование во текот на една година.
I was a student here myself in 1973-74, and it was a breaking point in my life. For the first time I had a chance to read what I wanted to read. Not what was curriculum or what I needed to read for my exam. I really felt when I was here that the world opened up. The sky became bigger. My horizons became bigger. And I feel that also happens with people coming from Balkan. They live in their very tough conflicts. In Srebrenica, in Mostar, in Mitrovica. And when they come here, the sky opens up. And you start to think new thoughts that maybe you didn't have the courage to think at home. And almost, I would say 90% of the students that have come here, they say it was an exceptional year in their life. It's like traveling on the road. You're driving too fast, you're tired, and you make a stop at the rest stop along the road. You breathe, you go to the toilet, you clean the car, and you think about where you're going. And why am I going so fast? What is there? And after stopping, you might even change your mind. You drive more relaxed. It's not so important to get there because maybe the road, the process, is what is important in life. So this is a school system I've seen in Denmark, Norway and Sweden, but I've not seen it in Europe and I've not seen it other places in the world. People simply take 1 year break to think about where they're going and why.
Well, we are students at the school. We have three different subjects, I can say. It's arts, literature, and social sciences, you can say. And the students are mostly Norwegians. We have also 5 or 6 foreigners, or people who have been living here in Norway, but are, they are not ethnic Norwegians. And we have 2 students from Serbia. They are also studying here through a project that Nansen School has.
My name is Anna. I'm from the northern part of Norway, and I study what can we call it? Philosophy, culture, and society studies. Yeah. And the reason I chose Nansen School is because I was really interested in the subjects.
Okay, my name is Anna. I'm from Oslo. I also go to the same course as her, Idea, Culture and Society, which is a mix of a lot of things, politics and philosophy and dialogue and conflict analysis and lots of different things all put together. So it's a very interesting course. We get to meet a lot of interesting people, like the foreign minister, Jonas Gahr Støre, came to visit us and held a lecture. So it's a great opportunity to meet people who are experts in their fields.
My name is Nikolai. I study creative writing here. Which is a different course from the more common one which these two are studying. But we get mostly we get the chance to attend the same courses and the same lectures, which there is a wide variety of which is probably the greatest thing about this school, is that you have very great freedom in what you want to what you want to study.
Групата, освен образовните институции, посети неколку места со цел родителите и наставниците да се запознаат со секојдневното живење во земјата, како и културните карактеристики на норвешкиот народ. Посетени беа локалната фабрика за рециклирање на отпад, Обштината Ојер, забавниот парк Хундерфосен, музејот Майхауген и ски скокалницата во Лилехамер. Престојот на родителите и наставниците во Норвешка го овозможи Насен Диалог Центарот Скопје, невладина организација кој го спроведува пилот проектот со двојазичната настава во училиштето во Предубиште. Во двете паралелки во училиштето учат по 12 ученици првооделенци на македонски и албански наставен јазик, а дополнителните наставни активности се изведуваат двојазично.